102, Springfield's Classic Rock. It's 5:35 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Mostly sunny today with a high of 49. Tomorrow, mix of sun and clouds with a high of 48. It is 32 right now in downtown Springfield.
We got a comedian on the show today. Comedian Gary Marino will be joining us on the phone after 8 o'clock today for some hilarious chit-chat between you and me and him.
He was great when he pitched for the Yankees.
Yes, he was very good. I forgot what happened to him at the end of his career.
Marino Rivera, right? Is that one? The Sandman?
You could always count on him to close things out.
There you go.
So there's that and other stuff this morning, too. Don't you worry about a thing. It's Bax and Nagle of Rock 102.
Rock 102 is the expert of all.
Rock 102, Springfield's Classic Rock. It's 5:50 in The Who with Bax and Nagle of Rock 102.
Yeah, but who was it?
That was The Who.
Yeah, but who was singing the song?
The Who.
Yeah, I know. Who was singing the song?
That was The Who, Steve, the name of the band.
All right.
I see what you're doing there. Little Abbott and Costello thing. Hilarious.
I hear that's a big hit up in where?
Where?
Yeah, there.
Where's there?
There.
There?
Up there.
Where?
Uh-huh. Sure. sunny today with a high of 49. Tomorrow, mix of sun and clouds with a high of 48. It is 32 in downtown Springfield.
Hollywood Trash is brought to you by the Western Mass Masons. Call the Western Mass Masons for all your foundation and chimney needs.
Somehow you still care about what's happening in Hollywood. So, from Tinseltown, 3,000 miles away, it's Steve Nagle's Hollywood Trash.
Stephen Colbert revealed People Magazine's Sexiest Man Alive last night on The Late Show.
How do we finish?
Dead last.
Damn it.
But John Krasinski is first.
Now,
The Office, Quiet Place.
You know, I'm secure in my manhood enough to admit this. I don't find him to be that attractive.
Well, he's just not your cup of tea.
No, he's not my cup of tea. But I'm just saying that if I'm judging men, on an attractiveness scale, he doesn't even make my top 50.
Don't you think he would look at us and go, "Yeah, I feel the same way about those two idiots."
Probably.
Yeah.
But I don't think I don't think we were given much of a shot to begin with.
He appeared on The Late Show and taught Stephen how to be sexy. He also told Stephen he's doing a Jack Ryan movie. As for how he felt when he got the news, he told People, just immediate blackout, actually zero thoughts other than maybe I'm being punked. Will this change anything for John? Probably not. He lives in Brooklyn with his wife, Emily Blunt, and their two daughters. He says, quote, I think it's going to make me do more household chores. Ha 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 ha.
Yeah, not so much.
He's actually not a bad looking man.
Yeah, but is he the sexiest man alive?
No, I am.
Honestly, Steve.
What?
You're not even in the top four.
Did you see me in that tux the other night? It was pretty hot.
Yeah.
One night a year, I get dressed up.
See, but I saw a booger hanging in your nose.
Well.
And I thought, that's going to kick a lot of the opportunities away.
Yeah, but that's what gives me... That's like, when we were talking about improprieties on people.
Right.
People with... they feel they're ugly because they have something wrong with them.
Sure.
That's my impropriety.
The booger.
It makes me handsome.
What does that say, really?
Nothing. It really doesn't say about much about the taste of many people. Britney Spears. In 3 days, she can wash her hands of Kevin Federline, when she sends him his final child support payment. The youngest, Jaden James, turned 18 in September. Britney paid K-Fed $10,000 at the beginning of the month. And he gets another $10,000 on Friday, and that's the ball game, folks. After Britney and Kevin divorced in 2007, they agreed on child support for Jaden and his older brother, Sean Preston. In 2018, it went up to $40,000 because the boys were with Kevin full-time. It went back down to $20,000 after Sean Preston turned 18 last year.
All right, but at the time, she probably had that kind of money.
Yeah.
And had that kind of earning potential.
Yep.
Now, maybe not so much.
Maybe not. Maybe not. Denzel Washington says director Ryan Coogler is writing a part for him in Black Panther 3, but it could be one of his final roles. At this point in my career, I'm only interested in working with the best. I don't know how many more films I will make. Probably not that many. I want to do things that I haven't done. A third Black Panther hasn't been officially announced, but Marvel boss Kevin Feige has previously mentioned a potential sequel. So there you go.
All right. Well, good choice.
Drew Barrymore has been criticized for being too touchy-feely with her guests, and she claims she's trying to tone it down. But that wasn't evident on her show yesterday. When she curled up on the couch with Martha Stewart, Drew asked Martha what makes her feel soft and gooey. Martha replied, "Soft and gooey treatment." Then Drew started caressing Martha's arm as she said, quote, "Soft and gooey treatment when you're treated like a lady?" Instead of rolling with it, Martha actually pushed Drew back, saying, quote, "You're the wrong gender." At that point, Drew flopped backwards on the couch as if she was devastated they weren't going to get it on right then and there. Is Drew Barrymore, I didn't know.
No, I just think she's just a
touchy-feely kind
of
girl.
Touchy-feely type of lady, that's it.
Maybe she likes both.
I don't know, and who's to judge, really?
Well, I'm just saying,
But clearly, Martha was not interested in her advances. And that's within her right to do.
Maybe she had that hot cougar fantasy. Or puma, in her case.
You know, she's been spending a lot of time with Snoop.
Yeah.
I've often wondered, what's going on with that?
Yeah.
Snoop Dogg.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This might be the worst Wheel of Fortune guess ever. Of course, we always say that whenever we have a Wheel of Fortune guess. On Monday's show, one of the puzzles was give yourself a round of applause, and there were enough answers to make it pretty obvious, but a contestant named Will Jordan guessed, treat yourself a round of sausage.
All right, did you see the video of this?
Yes.
The guy could not have been more confident in his answers.
Yeah.
In his guess. Like, he was puffing up. He could say, all right, man, I got this one. I got it. And then he mentioned the sausage. Which would have been my guess, too, frankly.
The next contestant successfully solved it, and Ryan Seacrest said, although, Will, I kind of like yours better. In an interview with the show's social correspondent, Maggie Sajak, Will explained his error. Quote, I will tell you when the lights are on, you know, and you know when the stars and Ryan Seacrest, Vanna White, I just went blank. But if you're a dad in retirement is watching the show, maybe cracks a beer and gets a laugh, it was totally worth it. Yeah, and you totally embarrassed your entire family, and you're not going to get anything out of it now.
I mean, there wasn't even a shred of doubt in this guy's mind what the answer was. It was hilarious.
I mean,
he was confidently incorrect.
It does look like that. Give yourself a round of sausage.
How many times have you thought, the day would be so much better if I had a nice round of sausage?
I think these clips are trying to go viral because nobody's watching Ryan Seacrest now.
They're not watching him do that.
No, but I don't think I think the popularity of Ryan Seacrest is dropping. Finally.
Boy, that's something that's well overdue.
What did that guy do?
I don't know. But he kind of took over for where the late Dick Clark left off.
Do you want a fully functional replica of the Tumbler Batmobile from the Dark Knight trilogy?
Of course I do.
The only drawback is only 10 are being made. They're not street legal and they cost $3 million. So good luck with all of that. Fashion magazine La Officielle just did a story about Kim Kardashian and her obsession with collecting nostalgia previously owned by dead celebrities. Items including Marilyn Monroe's dress, Princess Diana's jewelry, and Michael Jackson's smooth criminal hat.
Wow, she must have something to say.
Oh my God, the last time I was victimized by a smooth criminal was when Ray J pretended to be the clam burglar and devoured my Snappy Meal and that sex tape you can purchase on YouPorn for $39.95.
I'd hate to see the toy inside.
Well.
Caitlin?
Let me show you.
Okay.
Well, I never got that down and dirty with your mother, Chris Kim, but we once enjoyed a weekend of Tom Spoo's movies.
What did you see?
First, we watched the erotic drama Pies Wide Shut by Stanley Spielberg. Then it was on to the action mystery film about a bed that was too soaked to believe. Of course, that would be Nocturnal Emission Impossible.
This tip will
explode in 5 seconds.
What else did you see?
And finally, we watched the fast-paced, high-octane blockbuster where the best of the best all compete for who can successfully drop their loads all over their target. And that would be, you guessed it, Top Spum. Watch out for those flybys.
Yes,
yeah.
I will.
Talk to my goose. Talk to me. And that's your Hollywood trash on Rock 102.
To Springfield's Classic Rock at 612 and Billy Squire with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Sunny today with a high of 49. Tomorrow, mix of sun and clouds with a high of 48. It's 32 right now in downtown Springfield.
Comedian Gary Marino is going to be joining us after 8 o'clock today. He's coming to Westfield for a big comedy show. We'll talk all about that in a couple hours.
I like his sauce that goes over spaghetti.
Yeah, it's delicious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You ever park your boat in his lot down at the water?
At the marina?
At the marina.
The Marino Marina? No, I've never done that.
Remember he played football for the Miami Dolphins?
Dan Marino, yeah. I was always a big fan of Rita Moreno, too.
She won all those
Tony Awards and was on The Electric Company.
Dude, we're not alone.
Actually, right now we are. There's no one else here in the building.
At a House of Representatives committee hearing on unidentified anomalous phenomena Wednesday, lawmakers will hear from a number of witnesses about what they have seen and heard about UFOs. Held by the House Oversight Committee, the hearing titled Unidentified Anomalous Phenomena Exposing the Truth will begin at 11:30 a.m. Eastern. Luis Elizondo, a former Pentagon insider, veteran and investigator, retired Navy Rear Admiral Timothy Gallaudet, journalist Michael Schellenberger and Michael Gould, a former NASA administrator, are scheduled to give their testimonies.
Wow.
Yeah.
This is like the real deal. Yeah, you're finally going to get like real answers.
No, we're not. They keep saying that. You know, I don't understand why, you know, all of these people who have been elected over the course of, you know, the last 20 years or so.
Yeah.
And they all promise, oh, we're going to give you all the information.
Mm-hmm.
And then it never, ever, ever comes out.
Don't you understand what's going on here?
It's a conspiracy.
It's the deep state, Steve. There's a whole state. Illuminati that's run the whole damn thing. It's an industrial military complex. It's got the entire thing under wraps. The moment you let everybody know what's actually gone on there with the UFOs and the space aliens, that's when it all starts to collapse.
This hearing is the first since the summer of 2023, which was sparked by career intelligence official David Grush's allegations that the Pentagon has been operating a secret UFO retrieval program. If the UFO hearings catch on with the public, we could be in for quite a ride, said Bryce Zabel, UFO author and co-host of the podcast Need to Know with Russ Coldhart. Back in 1973, all of America was riveted to the Senate Watergate hearings, and the cover-up Nixon orchestrated will seem small compared to the one that would have been necessary to hide the truth about alien contact for nearly 8 decades now.
Mm-hmm.
So what will they say at this hearing?
Oh, man, you better be careful with your step.
Elizondo's eminent inside the Pentagon's hunt for UFOs alleges that the United States military has been running a UAP retrieval and reverse engineering program for years, even recovering non-human specimens.
Steve, I don't know how carefully you pay attention to the TikToks.
Mm-hmm.
I get a lot of my information on this very subject all the time. For whatever reason, you go down one rabbit hole and that's all you see.
Do you know why? Because we've mentioned it before and your phone's listening to you and that gets a part of your algorithm.
Perchance you're right. My whole point of this is what you are going to find is that not only have aliens been here, they have always been here.
Mm-hmm.
They built the pyramids. We are living in a multi-dimensional world, mm-hmm, where it is possible, and here's the thing that's going to freak you out, we may actually be the aliens.
Well,
suck on that one for a little bit.
Let that
ruminate in your coconut for a bit.
Let's see. Elizondo's book, Imminent, the Pentagon's Hunt for UFOs, allegedly the U.S. has been running these. Let me be clear. UAP are real. Advanced technologies not made by our government or any other government are monitoring sensitive military installations around the globe. That's what Elizondo will say, according to testimony published the day before the hearing. Yeah, okay, but you can say whatever you want. If you don't have any hard proof to show everybody,
Steve,
then what's the deal?
You know, listen, you can be as dismissive as you want. We've got all the proof. The government and this deeper state has suppressed all this stuff. It's not always available. There are some people that have been able to, you know, take some stuff out and show it. But then the entire complex will say, well, that's all a hoax. Well, maybe it's not. Maybe we're the ones who are a hoax.
Yeah, you could be right.
See what I'm getting at here?
Gallaudet,
the TikToks would not have steered me wrong on this.
Gallaudet, in his testimony, plans to repeat a claim he's made before to News Nation that an email that contained what is known as the Go Fast video disappeared from his and his colleagues' email servers. Go Fast shows a fighter pilot's encounter with a UAP. Well, didn't you copy the video and send it to a bunch of people? Forward, 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 UFO, you're not going to believe this? Isn't that the boomer method of doing that?
That's the boomer method of doing it, but as any IT person will tell you, don't click on links in your email.
Schellenberger will detail his reporting on the alleged Immaculate Constellation secret government program. A whistleblower revealed the alleged UFO program in which the Pentagon collects and quarantines information on UFO sightings. Department of Defense spokesperson Sue Goh has previously denied records of the program. Schellenberger will highlight the need for Congress and the White House to address UFOs. Michael Gould will outline new ways for NASA to be helpful on the UAP issue. Currently chief growth office at Redwire Space, Gold stresses in his testimony that he's speaking on his own behalf and not for any other organization.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we'll see.
I'm telling you what, there's a lot of people out there who are convinced that we are very, very close to having some level of disclosure, real actual disclosure.
Here's my prediction of what's going to happen today. Nothing. Nothing will be revealed. It'll all still be speculation. It'll all still be...
You remember a while back when there was a congressional hearing, mm-hmm. and this guy is speaking about UFOs and what we know and how some people have lost their lives trying to out this information because of the risk involved in doing so?
Yeah.
And when Congress asked for specific proof, he said, I'll be happy to give you that proof, but only in private chambers, not in a public display. Because of the deep ramifications of exposing this information.
At this point, what? What is the ramifications?
Well, Steve, listen.
What's the big deal if we find out that there actually is life on other planets, which isn't hard to believe, considering, we're the only planet that has sustainable life on
it. Well, it would be very arrogant for us to believe that in an ever-expanding universe, we would be the only ones out there. I mean, that would be very arrogant, and I've seen enough episodes of Star Trek to know that that's simply not true. However, the ramifications of this, from what I know on the TikToks, suggests that this information could dismantle nearly every religion on the planet.
Really?
Again, I'm citing TikTok, and it doesn't take a genius to go down that rabbit hole in the TikToks and follow along. That's what they're telling you. They're not telling you about the specifics of what's going on. They're just kind of dabbling around. They're like dancing on the edge of the cliff. That's what they're doing. So think about that. What could it be that is so destructive that for years we've been sweeping this under the rug? What could it be?
It's
more than just, are they out there with their little spaceships with ray guns and, getting very, very angry. It's not like that. It's a much broader threat.
Because I see, that's the thing. I think this is the next thing that we're going to have to, aliens are after. Why haven't they killed us yet?
Because they're not here to kill us. They're here to extract our DNA for their own survival.
Is that what you've heard on the TikToks before?
What do you think the rectal probing's for?
You know, whenever life gets you down, Mrs. Brown, and things seem hard or tough, and people are stupid, obnoxious, and daft, and you feel that you've had quite enough, just remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving and revolving at 900 miles an hour. That's orbiting at 19 miles a second, so it's reckoned the sun that is the source of all our power.
Did you ever see the
sun and you and me and all the stars that you can see?
Yeah. Did you ever see the film, what was it called, Attack from Mars?
I don't. Was that
Jack Nicholson was in that, and so basically the Martians land, right?
Yeah.
And the Martians are taking over. They're causing all kinds of problems. You know, they're smashing our buildings, they're killing our people, they're just, you know, disrupting football. I mean, all kinds of terrible things that are going on because of the Martians landing. And the only way to get rid of them, and I have prepared myself for this because I, you know, you can never be too careful. The only way to get rid of them was to play at a very loud volume the music of Slim Whitman.
Oh,
that
okay.
did it. Now, I've seen rooms cleared out many times every time I've put on a Slim Whitman album, and I know there's something to it. So I've prepared myself by collecting everything from the Slim Whitman catalog in hopes that someday, that if it happens, an alien attack happens on this planet.
You're going to play Slim Whitman.
I am going to be blasting Slim Whitman from my earbuds.
I get all of my UFO information from the great classic movie with Jeff Goldblum and Gina Davis, Earth Girls Are Easy.
Don't you think that aliens already know that? That's why they keep coming. It's 623 and Rock 102.
Don't you just love the sounds of the holiday season?
26 of Bax and Nagle and Rock 102.
Dan Brown has the full forecast for you.
Get a load of this. 12 days until the start of the Mayflower Marathon. Rock 102's Mayflower Marathon begins on Monday the 25th at 6 a.m. Goes on for 52 hours till Wednesday the 27th at 10 a.m. outside the South End Market at MGM Springfield. The goal, of course, is to fill as many trailers with non-perishable food donations as we can for the open pantry. They need your help right now, desperately. Start up your collection at work or at school, at home, around the neighborhood, whatever you can do. You can even donate online at rock102.com. Thanks to some of our sponsors, including Capital Moving and Storage, Xfinity, Camping World of West Hatfield, MGM Springfield, and many more. To get all the details about the Mayflower Marathon, go to rock102.com. It's the Mayflower Marathon beginning in 12 days on Rock 102 Springfield's Classic Rock.
Speaking of which, I have a message for you.
Yeah.
Because Tom Cotter, I was booking all these guests that we usually have on.
Sure.
The Mayflower Marathon. Tom Cotter's going to join us again.
Awesome.
On one of the days. But he, you know, he tells me the time, and then he says, tell Bax that I enjoyed his carrot penis creation at the Black Tie event. Very, very mature. And I said something to him that I can't even say on the radio, so
sure.
I'll have to tell you off the air.
See, we were playing with our food at the Bright Nights Ball.
Yeah.
And let me just say that it got the reaction I was expecting it
to get. Well, I mean, what do they expect? They invite two knuckle-dragging Neanderthals like us to a black tie event and then put a carrot salad in front of us like we're not going to make a penis out of it.
We had to.
Yeah.
And by the way, it was a big hit on the table. Everybody laughed.
You know what? I'm beginning to question that Judy Matt's judgment about inviting us to this thing. You ready to laugh?
Yes.
Laugh.
It's Bax and Nagle's joke of the day.
I'm funny how? I mean, funny like I'm a clown, I am usual.
On Rock 102.
I make you laugh?
Springfield's classic rock.
A polar bear walks into a bar and says to the bartender, I'll have a rum and Coke.
Okay.
And the bartender says, whoa, what's with the big paws? And he goes, I was born with them. Ah, you see?
Big paws.
Yeah. He wasn't talking about the time it took him for him to say Coke. He was talking about his giant things on the end of his arms there. Oh, man.
Bax and Nagle in the morning on Rock 102, Springfield's classic rock.
6:33 with Bax and Nagle and Rock 102. It's time for news. Here's local radio icon Steve Nagle.
Thanks, Bax. State officials are now providing a detailed breakdown of 15 active fires in our state, including 4 in western Massachusetts. We should be playing Tom Preddy's breakdown while we talk about this story.
How about Wildfire by Michael Martin Murphy?
Ooh, look at you with the obscure music.
What are you talking about? That was a big hit back in the 70s.
Yeah, well, so was Breakdown in, maybe the 80s, but it's still a classic today.
Hmm. Well, there's still plenty of time to figure out what I want to do.
Since the drought started in November? The drought's been going on for more than longer than that, hasn't it?
Since at least last month. Early last month.
I thought it was the end of September.
Could be.
Yeah. Anyway, more officials say more than 500 wildfires have burned across our state, raising more than 1,500 acres of land. That's more than half of the fires in our state for the entire year and almost three-quarters of the total acres burned. The state is tracking 15 fires across the state on Tuesday, yesterday, and four of those were in western Massachusetts. The Department of Conservation and Recreation say fires are still burning in Northampton, Munson, Montgomery, and Northfield.
The governor was out talking about it yesterday, and she was saying, and I agree, now is simply not the time to be burning stuff. Even if you're thinking the most innocent of situations, like, hey, let's sit around the campfire, make s'mores, and hang out, and drink beers and stuff. That's a bad idea.
Somebody made a point on that Route to Entire listener line the other day about how people are throwing cigarette butts out the window because there's no more ashtrays left in cars.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess if you're going to do that, just carry a cup with you that you can put it in, like a water cup, you know?
Water cup?
Extinguish
just,
it.
Just put it in your beer can. Right there in the beverage holder.
Well, your beer can, and then but just be careful you don't get open flames near the 151 rum that you're drinking as you're driving down the street.
No, well, that's irresponsible.
Because then that would spontaneously, be very irresponsible. You don't want to mix flames with high potency alcohol like that.
No, but in a low alcohol beverage, say like a beer, you just flick your cigarette right there in the little hole there, and yeah. I'm sure your Pabst Blue Ribbon will extinguish the flame.
My one of my hobbies is watching FAFO videos. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yes.
And find out.
Yes, I do. Yeah. I love those.
I really enjoy watching these douchebag kids light 151 rum on fire and then try to drink it, and then it spreads everywhere. Like that wasn't going to happen.
Like they never saw that something bad might happen.
Or people who put, like, gasoline on fires and thinking that, it's just gasoline. How big of an explosion? You don't need very much gasoline to cause a minor explosion.
No, you don't.
You probably need less than a quarter of a gallon I'm not talking like a dynamite type of thing, but a poof that could burn your entire face off. Or catch fire with the rest of the gas can. That's the ones I like. When the guy, he's taking the gas can and he lights the campfire. And then he walks away from it thinking he's safe. And then he throws something in to light the fire. And the drippings from the gas can go into the gas can.
Yeah.
Those are my favorite.
Those are fun.
Yeah.
I've been going on Reddit a lot lately.
Yeah.
Just to watch the WTF videos.
Mm-hmm.
And there was one. And this is, okay. Putting your fire pit in action right now is a bad idea. This is a really bad idea. We talk about this every 4th of July. There was a video I saw just the other day of a guy who had like a barrel that he cut in half. Try to imagine this, like one of the big plastic barrels and those big 50-gallon drum type of things. He fills it with Roman candles, maybe about 100 Roman candles, maybe even more. I don't even know how many Roman candles would fit in a half barrel, but they're all kind of, stuck all going in the same direction. And the guy had the barrel affixed to his chest. And then he had a buddy.
I got a buddy.
That lit the fuse, and then all of a sudden, all the Roman candles that are on this guy's chest start to go off.
Oh.
Well, the Roman candles typically go forward, when they launch, right?
Yeah.
Hard to believe, but it seemed to also have some sort of percussion going backwards too.
You don't say.
Yes, and the flame, the sparks, you may have also caused irreparable damage to his head. So again, F around and find out. You do something stupid and bad things happen, you shouldn't be surprised when it goes south. And starting a fire right now on the 13th of November is one of those things that's a big mistake. Sorry to take so much time. I'll step off my soapbox and defer to you, the man doing news.
The man doing news? Is that what you told? Why? Until another man?
Until you give me another reason, something else to call you.
Local radio icon, Steve Nagle.
I've already mentioned that.
Yeah. A Springfield man faces firearm and drug charges after officers were called to Dawes Street for a ShotSpotter activation. According to the Springfield police, at around 8:50 p.m. on Monday, officers were called to the 100 block of Dawes Street for that activation. A suspect matching the description of a shooter was located on Catherine Street. Approximately 10 minutes later, 22-year-old Melvin Mercedes Rodriguez of Springfield was arrested on the 700 block of State Street after police found a loaded firearm in his waistband and 14 grams of crack cocaine. He's charged with a slew of charges, including a drug violation near a school or a park. I bet he's fighting that one.
Yeah, good luck.
That's the one. But hey, another one off the street.
You see that story yesterday? We talked about it. There was a problem on Magazine Street, but the local news could not say exactly what the problem was. You see what the problem was?
What?
There was some guy chucking axes at police officers.
Really?
Yeah. Like he was just, you know, he had an axe and decided to chuck it at people, in particular, cops.
Well, that's always a smart move.
No, it is not. F around and find out.
Yeah, that's probably something that would get you injured more so than you trying to throw an axe at somebody.
Now, again, I don't think there was a target. I don't think it's like one of these axe bars where you can throw axes for fun. This was at police officers, which I think is a mistake.
I just watched, you know, now you said that there was a video I saw online this morning about this guy. I think he was like, he's like a government official or something, or he was, or he's going to be, or whatever.
Right.
And it was a video of him from a few years ago where he's, there's these like, what do they call those? The fife and drum people?
Yeah.
Where they're dressed up like the Patriots.
Right.
And the guys, there's three guys doing drums, and then this guy, this politician guy, he takes the axe. It was like an axe throwing thing. And he's supposed to hit the target with the axe.
Yeah.
And he throws it so high that it goes over the target and then hits one of the drum guys in the arm.
Yeah. Well,
I'm like, who? It looked like everything was set up, you know, the way it was supposed to be. But it doesn't seem like anybody was really following any safety protocol, like getting out of the way, or, you know, because they were behind the target. Wouldn't you not play your drums there?
I would play towards the side. Yeah. I would even play behind him in case, you know, he got too rambunctious with his with the back motion.
Yeah.
You know, I to the side.
I don't know. I don't remember who it was, but it was like there's another FAFO guy.
Yeah. Again, if you're in any kind of band, never throw axes at the drummer.
No, that's not good either. Three women who were hit by a fallen tree in Orange over the summer are heading to court to try and get justice from the property owner, whom they say is responsible for the near deadly incident. It allegedly wasn't the property owner's first fallen tree. The victim's attorneys claim it was the second time in just 6 months, and the latest situation came with much more than a tree cleanup, as three women are now picking up the pieces of their lives. That's a little dramatic.
Yeah, they look pretty messed up, though.
3 months ago, Danielle Bushy walked with ease. Now she can barely walk up the stairs. Life is really tough. I can't get up myself, and I can't walk and do anything myself. It's really tough. I was so independent before, and life has been very depressing, she said. Danielle said her sister, Brittany Bushy, and Melissa Chiasson were also injured in the August incident. In a lawsuit, they're accusing Daniel Bushy's neighbor, Peter Rockland, of not taking care of rotting trees on his rental property that caused all of this. The problem was preventable. It was an easy fix. There's people out of this area that do this kind of work. He refused or failed to act, said attorney Michael Kelly. Kelly provided Western Mass News with the body cam footage from the incident. Daniel Bushy's injuries have kept her in body braces. Brittany Bushy continues to have memory and hearing loss. I can't remember much that happened minutes ago, anything from a couple of days ago in the short term. So they got pretty messed up from this whole thing.
Yeah, they did. And, you know, the thing is, you know, as a property owner, if you have trees on your property that are close to a driveway, yeah, a road, another building,
yeah,
and you don't take care of it, and you know it's a diseased tree, I don't know. Good luck. Good luck with the jury on that one.
Well, Kelly also said Rockland doesn't seem to be the friendly neighbor we all hope to have.
Mm.
They say neither he nor his insurance lawyers have responded to the victims or their attorneys. We contacted him. He picked up the phone and said, "Is she dead?" And we said, "No, thank God." And then he hung up the phone and blocked us.
Really?
Well, I guess he was concerned enough to see if she was dead.
Yeah. You know, tree removal is very expensive. but so is losing a lawsuit. And I think, you know, given the choice, get rid of the tree.
You know, is that something you can claim on your insurance to get rid of something that's a potential hazard to your home?
I may be wrong about this. I'm not sure insurance covers that.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, I think that's why, you know, oftentimes it's like an outlay of cash to get rid of a tree, as opposed to, say, you know, making a claim with my insurance company to get rid of it.
It cost me quite a bit of money to get rid of two trees.
Yeah.
Not at the same time either. I had these two trees in my front yard. And the crappy thing is it kind of ruins the aesthetics of what was there, because these trees were probably at least 50 years old.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is, the first windstorm I had after I moved in there, half of the tree had fallen down, and I'm like, all right, I got to get rid of this thing because the branches are just snapping off this thing left and right. Got rid of that one. That was the one closest to the house. And then there was another one out in the side yard, which was awesome because it provided a lot of shade. But one time, one of the branches fell off, and it was nothing but a hole. Like, entire branch was hollow. So I had to get that one taken down, too, because you could get killed.
Yeah, of course.
Kill somebody else that, you know, kids walking around in the yard or something like that. It's just, you got to get rid of it. But I know it's expensive, but that's where my question was. Does the insurance cover
somebody
who can't afford to do a $1,500 tree job?
Unless it lands on your house, I'm not and even then I'm not even sure.
Yeah.
I mean, I think they'll pay for the damage to your house. I don't think they'll pay to have the tree removed.
Right.
So, I mean, it's like
But also, if you have a deductible, you're probably already halfway there to get the, you know what I mean?
For
$500 to reduce your rates going up, you might as well just come up with the other $500 it is to either trim the tree or get rid of it, you know?
Yeah. I mean, I may be wrong about that. That's been my understanding that that's how it works.
Well, we've spent way too much time on this.
Have we?
Let's move along. It's going to be sunny today with a high of 49. Tomorrow, mix of sun and clouds with a high of 48. It's 32 right now in downtown Springfield. I'm Steve Nagle, and that's the news on Rock 102. Oh, yeah.
Rock 102 and the Springfield Thunderbird.
Rock 102, Springfield's classic rock at 6:52, and Jimi Hendrix of Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
It is going to be sunny today with a high of 49. Tomorrow, mix of sun and clouds with a high of 48. It's 32 right now in downtown Springfield.
Rock 102 and Affordable Waste Solutions is going to take over the Mass Mutual Center on November 22nd to host the Mayflower Marathon Night with the Springfield Thunderbirds. Come out and watch the Thunderbirds take on the Charlotte Checkers and kick off the Mayflower Marathon on the 22nd. It's a Friday night. First 3,000 fans in attendance will get a Mayflower Marathon goalie glove oven mitt. How badass does that sound? That's Friday, November 22nd at the Thunderdome from the Affordable Waste Solutions and Rock 102, Springfield's classic rock. Now, yesterday, we're actually at the Falcons office.
Yeah.
Recording some stuff and getting ready for it. Man, I love parking downtown. That is just so much fun.
So convenient.
It is so convenient.
Well, I get it, because they're finishing building that garage down there, and it's still taking time. So that whole area down there is kind of a mess, which is why a lot of people park at MGM to go to the Thunderbirds games, because it's easier.
That's what I did.
Well, I mean, because you're not going to, unless you get there at 3:00 in the afternoon, you're probably not going to get on street parking anywhere. I parked about 5 blocks away on Main Street, to which then I was boxed in by a van.
Oh, come on.
So really? I had to do the Austin Powers move, trying to get the golf cart turned around in the hallway. And people are a-holes that are also driving alongside of you.
Of course they are.
So there's this one guy, I'm trying to pull out of this spot. I'm trying to do it, like, meticulously. And he's, like, right up on the spot. And I'm like, I can't move anywhere. Like, it would be easier for me to move out of the way if you just backed up a little.
Sure.
But now he can't back up because he's got people behind him. He's now, like, beeping at me like I'm taking my time. I'm like, what do you want me to do? This van boxed me in and went over the line, like the over the parking line.
Yeah.
People just make my head want to explode.
And especially since, I mean, I understand it. We're all, if you got to park downtown, everyone's kind of going a little crazy because the city desperately needs that parking garage to be open. And on a whole bunch of meters downtown, like on Dwight Street.
Yeah.
You know, they're all bagged off. You can't park there.
I don't care about walking. I walk all the time. It doesn't bother me if I have to walk 5 or 6 blocks to get somewhere. It's about the spaces that are open. There's not enough spaces open. That's the problem. Even 5, 6 blocks away, that was the first one I found, and I got lucky doing that. So, I don't know.
I know. The downtown is real chopped up, but thankfully this thing is... I don't know what the date is, what the proposed finished and reopened date for this is, but hopefully it's soon because it really has caused a lot of problems downtown, and it will make things so much easier if you can park in that facility every single day for everybody.
Yeah, yeah. Well, jumping tracks, because I just want to point this out. There's a 19-year-old YouTuber named Norm.
Norm?
Yeah, Normie. I don't know. Norme. Whatever, is trying to break a world record by locking himself in a room for a full month with no light. And the craziest part is he's almost done. He went in October 16th.
Yeah.
He got booted from YouTube and Twitch a few months ago for another endurance stunt where he didn't sleep for 12 days.
Oh, no. That's not good.
Well,
what happens if you don't get light for a month? What happens to you?
You have a beautiful digital memorial on YouTube for you.
That's what happened.
Yeah. Somebody puts up a nice, hey, listen, let's all remember Normie or Norm, whatever his name was.
Yeah, rest in peace, Normie.
Rest in peace, whose neurological system is completely shot because he's tried to, you know, do. Prisoners have done it before. You've heard of people being locked in solitary confinement in like some of these world prisons that, you know, have no light or, you know, how many movies have you seen where that was depicted?
Yeah.
In like a Shawshank Redemption, for example.
Good point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that kind of thing happened. Maybe even still does. Who knows?
I don't know, man. But not sleeping for 12 days. That's actually very dangerous.
That's dumb.
It is stupid. And you know what? It's once you've done it or attempt to do it, what do you get out of it?
I don't know. You know, all the dumb stuff I've done in my life, I've never made money off of any of it. Like, seriously, I could be...
Even the legitimate stuff you've done, you haven't made a lot of money on.
I guess if I had just recorded it all and put it up on YouTube, I would have been swimming in millions of dollars by now.
You just got in too late.
Yeah, I guess so.
It's 6:58 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
And now, Bax's View from the Couch. Brought to you by Rocky's Ace Hardware, the one-stop quick in-and-out store for property managers, landlords, handymen, and contractors.
Hey, good morning, sports fans. How the heck are you, folks? Thrilling news. The Emirates NBA Cup in-season tournament is already underway. How that snuck up on everybody is anybody's guess. But for the second year in a row, the NBA will provide you with a smattering of thrills by scheduling games that might have already been on the schedule even without a disruptive in-season tournament to get in the way. Last year, the NBA introduced the NBA Cup in-season tournament, and I'm sure that many of you will recall that it was the Lakers who walked away with the first NBA Cup championship by beating the Indiana Pacers 123-109. Sure, it was an exciting blowout, but since it was almost a full year ago, let's review how this thing works. The NBA Cup is broken into a two-tiered tournament. The first one is known as group play. That's where all 30 NBA teams have been randomly separated into groups of 5. Each team will play 4 games in hopes of advancing into the knockout round. From there, the top 8 teams will compete against each other in a bracket-style process of elimination. The 2 remaining teams will vie for the NBA Cup championship. Exciting, huh? Oh, you don't know the half of it. Now, since the tournament has already begun disrupting the NBA regular season, where do things stand with the Boston Celtics? Well, let's just say they got the short end of the stick by being selected in the East Group C, with Cleveland, Chicago, Atlanta, and Washington. And the opening game against the Hawks ended with the Celtics losing their 3rd game of the season, 117-116. Does that mean the Celtics are out? No, it does not. In fact, there's still plenty of ways the Celtics could go on and win this largely irrelevant and disruptive tournament. However, win or lose, I can assure you of this. Nobody cares who wins, and nobody ever will, except the folks at Emirates Airlines, who spent a fortune to sponsor this foolishness for the next several years. Good choice on that one. Money well spent. But hey, enough of my yapping. Sports brought to you by Rockies Ace Hardware. You know, there's so many power tools on sale right now at Rockies. I mean, I'm looking at the flyer on my phone. I'm looking at the Rockies website. You can pick up a paper copy at the store. DeWalt Power Tools, Milwaukee, Craftsman. Heck, what power tools aren't on sale right now at Rockies Ace Hardware? I'm Bax. That's my view from the couch.
Rock 102, Springfield's classic rock.
Rock 102, Springfield's classic rock. It's 7:13. And Elton John with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Sunny today with a high of 49. Tomorrow, mix of sun and clouds with a high of 48. It is 32 right now in downtown Springfield.
You know, I love it when news organizations feel as though there are certain stories that need to be told. And there are stories that I could probably go without knowing a whole hell of a lot about. CNN reported this story yesterday, and Western Mass News also reiterated the story. And in fact, the lovely Abby Carnevale did the story, and I felt so bad for her because I knew this could not have been a simple thing for her to get through. But she did it like a champ because she's a total pro. But you saw the story about how long doctors say is too long to sit on the toilet?
Yes, I saw that on WFSB down in Hartford.
Right.
But it's one of these. What happens is these national news organizations make these stories, and then they feed them to their little, you know, affiliates throughout the country.
Right.
So if you're part of that affiliate, they pick up the story, and basically they just voice it over as if they're doing the story, but they're not. They're just making it localized in the best way that they can.
Yeah, how can we make the story about sitting on a toilet local?
So here's the, you want me to read the story?
Yeah, sure.
Let's be honest. People have a habit of bringing their phones to the bathroom. I've been guilty of myself, and chances are that someone is on the toilet reading this article right now. A 3-minute trip to the loo can easily turn into 15 minutes of reading, scrolling, and posting.
Mm-hmm.
It might seem harmless way to pass the time when you're going number two. However, experts warn that prolonged sitting on the toilet can harm your health. It's been proven to weaken pelvic muscles and increased risk of hemorrhoids, said Dr. Lao Zhu, a colorectal surgeon at the University of Texas Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas. When patients present to me with complaints, one of the main areas we have to delve deeply into is spending a lot of time on the toilet. Here's what's going on when you overstay your toilet time. Potty problems for sitting too long.
Okay.
People should spend an average of 5 to 10 minutes on the toilet, according to Dr. Farah Manzur, an assistant professor of medicine. Whatever. She's a doctor. Why is it a problem if you stay longer? First, here's a short physics lesson. Gravity keeps us grounded on Earth, but that same gravity also forces the body to work harder to pump blood back up to the heart.
Uh-huh.
The old open oval-shaped toilet seat compresses the buttocks.
Yes.
Keeping the rectum in a lower position than if you were sitting on the couch.
Sure.
With gravity pulling the lower half of the body down, the increased pressure affects your blood circulation.
Mm-hmm.
That's what happened to Murtaugh in Lethal Weapon.
I'm getting too old for this.
Well, remember he had the bomb on the toilet and he couldn't get off the toilet and his legs were locked in place?
Yes.
And he couldn't move, so then Riggs had to come along, and he had to like do that like hand clasp thing and pull him off so the toilet would explode. I mean, it's totally feasible.
Oh, yeah. I mean, like in real life.
Yeah. It becomes a one-way where the blood enters, but blood really can't go back. As a result, the veins and blood vessels surrounding... I don't even feel comfortable talking about this.
Well, see, this was the part...
Yeah.
So, like, the ending part of a certain... condition, you could say, could result from sitting on a toilet too long, not related to, well, I mean, related to weakened pelvic muscles. I don't want to get into the specifics of it, but poor Abby Carnevale had to say it, and I just felt like, oh, honey, that's terrible. You poor thing.
Well, should I replace those words?
If you must.
As a result, the veins and blood vessels surrounding the leather Cheerio, if you will, or the stink portal, or the brown star, or the chocolate starfish.
What are you trying to say?
What I'm trying to say is that you can't sit on the loo for too long.
I see, yes.
Unless you have an Uncle John's bathroom reader. I love those things.
Right.
Yeah. Force straining can increase.
You don't want to be turned inside out because you're spending too much time on the can.
Yeah, this whole article is talking about how detrimental this can be to your health if you spend more than 10 minutes on the toilet every day. Who is spending that much time? Like, I want to do my business, and I want to get out of there in a reasonable amount of time, like 5 minutes.
Dude, I can take 15 to 20 minutes on a good day.
What are you doing in there?
That's me time. That's my own private time.
What are you doing? Are you sitting there with your pants down around your ankles the entire time?
Yes.
Why?
To catch up on things. I got my phone, I'm reading books, I'm reading stories, I'm going through the TikToks.
Do you have a medical condition?
No.
Then why are you spending that much time on the toilet? I can see people who have, like, remember we were talking yesterday about the kid who crapped in the dad's office, in the girlfriend's dad's office.
Right.
You know, and people were saying, why didn't you just go in your pants if you have if there's an issue?
Understood.
Yeah.
That's an emergency situation. But in a regular day, 10 minutes doesn't give me a whole lot of time to get all my my work done.
What are you doing in there?
I get some of my best work done in the bathroom. Sometimes I'm preparing for the show. Sometimes I'm looking at I may be at a certain level of Candy Crush, and I just don't want to leave. You know,
I don't take my phone out usually when I'm in the bathroom.
You don't know what you're missing.
No, I am know what I'm missing. I don't want to be in a bathroom, especially if I'm in a public bathroom.
Public bathrooms are different. I mean, I want to be in and out in a public bathroom, but in the comfort of my own home.
Yeah.
That's like a creature comfort right there.
A creature comfort?
Yes.
Really?
Sure. I'll go in there. I'll do my business. I'll maybe catch up on some emails.
No. Do the business. Then, do what you got to do to clean yourself up and get back out of the bathroom.
I don't think it's so unusual that a man wants to go in there and be left alone for the private time, just him and his thoughts.
What are you doing in there for 20 minutes? 20 minutes?
I've just told you what I'm doing in there. I'm catching up with the day.
No, that's not. You should be in and out. In and out as you don't have to rush, but you don't have to take more than 5 minutes if you're on a regular schedule.
You can't rush a situation like that. I mean, it's got to be the right time. And I don't even
293-1021. How long do you spend on the toilet?
Jesus, afraid of this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, listen,
This lady says my husband can sit there for 30 to 45 minutes. Where can I find this article? Well, I'll have to send that.
Here's the only real issue I find in our home. We only have one bathroom. It's a one bathroom house.
Yeah.
So I try to be. In my own time, when I'm home alone, that's when I'll take the most amount of time.
Yeah.
When my wife is home, then I'll try to step up my game a little bit. I'll try to, be less possessive of the room.
I like this guy. CNN is not credible. Everyone knows this. Yeah. So is every other news organization that's out there.
I don't think when we're talking, accusing a news gathering organization of being, part of fake news.
Fake news!
That this is part of
Sad!
It. I think this is probably, it is probably based on some level of scientific discovery that maybe 10 minutes after that elapsed, you tag out and you go on.
Look what happened to Elvis Presley. Spent so much time on the toilet, he could never get off.
Well, he had to. He had something, some blockages. He had to, he had obstructions.
Well, you think the cheeseburger grease would have progressed the OxyContin that he was taking. I know that those opioids tend to bind you up a little bit.
Exactly.
But, you think a big king burger for the king would have pushed all that out.
The king died in his throne the way he would have wanted to go.
Yeah. Somebody says that's where I hide from my kids.
See, I wouldn't be alone on this. This is a good place to have some private moments just for yourself. That's it. There's nothing really going on in there.
All right. Well, I mean, this is what I was talking about weeks ago when I said, I find myself sitting in my car when I, like, get to my destination. I'll sit there.
This is no different. It's almost the same exact thing.
If I have time, you know what I mean? If I have time,
uh-huh.
I will sit there and waste that time doing the scrolling and doing all of the emails and stuff like that.
Right.
But that's my time.
Yeah. This is more satisfying to me because at the same time that I am consuming information, I am also releasing other things.
Yeah, you think
so? It's like the circle of life.
You know, you think people would be calling left and right to talk about this?
I don't think people are comfortable talking about it. I think it makes people very uncomfortable. But you know, 10 minutes. I mean, if we've been talking about this for 10 minutes,
yeah.
By this point, I'd probably be wrapping up.
All right, maybe we should wrap it up.
It's 7:23 on Rock 102.
Rock.
It's 7:27 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Dan Brown has the full forecast.
This week on Baxy's Musical Podcast, my guest is Ryan Adams, 7-time Grammy nominee, a guy who has had more than 29 albums out since for the last 24 years. Amazingly prolific guy. He is about to release his previously shelved album from 2006 called Black Hole. That's going to be out on Friday, and he's also coming to the Bosch Center in Boston, the Schubert Theater, on the 25th of November. It's a really interesting interview about a guy who found himself in a bit of trouble and is trying to desperately claw his way back. It's pretty powerful stuff, and you can hear it on Apple Podcasts, SoundCloud, Spotify, rock102.com, the Rock 102 app, and also on YouTube, brought to you by Metro Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram at Chicopee, and Rock 102 Springfield's Classic Rock.
Here is how dumb people are. This is the story I was thinking of that I wanted to talk about real quick.
Yeah.
Costco customers with dairy allergies may need to check their fridge due to 80,000 pounds of the retailer's butter being recalled for packaging missing the, quote, contains milk statement, according to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
Is there anybody that is not aware that butter is made from milk or cream?
Apparently not. The recall for 1,300 cases containing 79,200 pounds of butter was initiated on October 11th by a wholesaler in Littlefield, Texas, due to an undeclared allergen. The allergen in the Kirkland Signature Unsalted Sweet Cream Butter and Kirkland Signature Salted Sweet Cream Butter was milk. What? They're putting milk in our butter?
Isn't that the primary ingredient in all butter?
No. On November 7th, the recall was classified as a class 2, meaning the use of or exposure to the butter may cause temporary or medically reversible adverse health consequences. It's butter.
It's
milk.
It's
milk
always been made of milk.
The federal agency's record shows that the butter was distributed throughout Texas, but which parts were not disclosed. If it's also unclear if any customers have suffered allergic reactions to the butter. The only allergic reaction I had was the price of the butter, which was...
that made you choke.
That made me choke.
That was a choking
hazard.
That
was like a Marquis Salomon choke on a sandwich choke when I saw the price of it. What to do with the recalled butter? The FDA did not provide instructions for customers who have already purchased the butter, probably thinking you're going to be okay.
You know what I would do? I would go to Costco and say, listen, I'll take a bunch of that butter off your hands for half the price.
I would imagine if you have a dairy allergy, you are well aware that you have a dairy allergy, and you know that butter is probably one of the things that you cannot consume. Who is this effect? You know what it comes down to? It's the FDA, because you didn't label it properly.
Right.
Somebody could sue that company because they said, hey, I ate this butter and I'm a dairy allergen and I didn't know that this was going to make me sick.
You're going to be spending a lot more time in 10 minutes in the toilet if you eat the tainted butter.
I mean, I can see like other products like margarine, you know, like a Livio or something like that not containing a milk. There's got to be a product out there that probably doesn't contain a milk butter-like substance.
Sure, there's all kinds of replacements.
Right, but actual butter.
You'd have to be an idiot not to know this.
Yeah, we're living in a really bad movie.
It's 7:30. We have news next to Rock 102. 7:34. With Bax and Nagle on Rock 102, it's time for news brought to you by Wohler's Builders for sleek office makeovers to upgrading classrooms or adding ADA accessibility. Here's local radio icon Steve Nagle.
Thanks, Bax. And of course, the hard-hitting news. A 22 News viewer spotted a family of bears on their trail cam in Great Barrington last week. The video posted on TikTok received over 17,000 likes in less than a day. In the video, you can see the mama bear being followed by her three cubs at around 5:30 p.m. Go back to that guy who said CNN is not a credible news source. Because everywhere else is.
Yeah, right.
I'm glad to see this on the. I'm on this side of the camera to see this. IDK, who I am, posted in a comment.
Steve,
why don't they just say one user?
Do you have any follow-up stories about the porridge?
Yeah. Well, actually, there was a young girl who was mauled to death by three bears in the woods. She was covered in porridge.
Yeah, but she was, you know, they're sleeping, and all of a sudden they got way out of control. They are bears, after all.
Yeah, like, who's eating all my porridge? Oh, it was that girl. Well, let's take care of them, guys. According to Mass Bears, black bears are common. And then they go into this whole thing about the black bears again.
Aren't you at least a bit curious?
It's the same thing. It's the same paragraph. According to Mass Bears, black bears are common in Massachusetts with an estimated 4,500 bears living in the state. Black bears live all over western Massachusetts, as far east as the I-95 corridor in the northern part of the state. Black bears are omnivores, and most of their diet is plants.
Well, this is front page news.
I'm telling you, man, you are getting hard hitting news there. We have is that somebody trying to call here?
That's what it appears to be.
Why don't we answer that?
You sure?
Yeah, why not?
All right, Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Good morning. It's Mike Cantor from Connecticut. How are you?
Good. What's going on?
Well, I was driving to work, and Bax and Nagle were talking about the bowel movements. And they said, I guess no one wants to call in.
Yeah.
But I couldn't call in because I was on my way to work.
Yeah.
It's too late to talk about that.
Well, no, go ahead. What do you want to say?
Keep it clean if you can, though.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I say, like, when I go into it, it takes, like, about 2 to 3 or 4 minutes. Just get it done,
yeah,
and you leave.
Get it done, go. What are you sitting there on TikTok for 20 minutes?
I'm thrilled that you're able to be so efficient. Not everybody has that option. Some people have to spend more time just naturally.
Right. Well, you know, if you're a bit constipated or something, there's this thing that you put your feet on.
The squatty potty?
Are you in the bathroom right now?
No. I'm in work now.
What kind of place do you work at?
I work at a place that makes elevator phones and load wares.
Are you on an elevator phone right now?
Yeah.
No, I'm in the shop.
Elevator
phones are all over the place.
All right. Well, listen, thank you very much for your input. We could talk about this forever, but we are in the middle of a newscast.
Right. Thank you very much for taking my call.
Well, we also gave him permission to talk freely about what he wanted to talk about.
Well, I think
about.
We should all share.
Yeah,
I mean, that's all important
stuff.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
You guys are great. Thanks a lot.
All right. You're welcome. Yeah. Okay. Very good.
That was worth taking that call.
Totally worth it. Well, you know, listen, it was such a big story. Local news covered it, not just here, but in Hartford.
Local news covered it because there was nothing else to talk about.
You had a guy throwing axes on Magazine Street.
Yeah,
there was plenty of talked about.
Nah, I don't want to hear about that. I don't want to hear about details of a story of why there was a large police presence the other night. I want to know what's going on in your bathroom.
I think that's my business.
Identified two suspects wanted in connection with allegedly placing a skimming device inside of a convenience store over the weekend. According to the Springfield Police Department, detectives are investigating after four incidents of skimmers were located by an employee or retrieved by a suspect inside convenience stores. Police are looking to identify the suspects pictured who they have, like, you know, on their Springfield Police Department page in 22. Police are looking to identify who placed the skimming device over a point-of-sale device inside at least one of the convenience stores. Businesses are being urged to be vigilant in checking for skimming devices at their point-of-sale ATM devices. Nowhere in this story does it say what store was compromised. Which you think you'd want to know if you were a customer of that store, that you might want to change your bank card number or something if you had purchased something there over the week.
But if you know a skimmer was present, if they're already reporting that one was present, then they've probably already removed it, and you don't want anyone affecting the business in a negative way.
I guess so, but
That's how I would look at it.
I also, if I was the one that got scammed by this, I would want to know where it is.
Sure.
A federal judge sentenced a Massachusetts Air National Guard member to 15 years in prison Tuesday for leaking classified military documents about the war in Ukraine. Actions prosecutors say the country's national security at risk, endangered other military members, and damaged U.S. relationships with his allies. Jack Teixeira had pleaded guilty in March to 6 counts of willful retention and transmission of national defense information under the Espionage Act, nearly a year after his arrest in the most consequential national security breach in years. Wearing an orange jumpsuit in court, he showed no reaction as he was sentenced by U.S. District Judge Indra Talwani. Today, Mr. Teixeira has paid a very heavy price for the laws he broke, for the incredible damage that he caused, acting Massachusetts Attorney General, or U.S. Attorney Josh Levy said afterwards. The significant sentence sends a powerful message to every individual who holds a top secret clearance. Hmm. He shared these on was it Discord? Or was he on? I think it was on one of these things.
Yeah.
Like playing video games.
I don't remember exactly where. You know, the thing that that leaps out at me is he is from my hometown of Rehoboth, Massachusetts. Graduated from Dighton Rehoboth Regional High School in 2020.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, how just about like that?
He might be the most he might just be the most famous person ever graduate from that high school.
How about that?
Because he's being talked about all over the country.
Listen, we need to answer another call because
okay.
People are calling.
All right. Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Hey, it's George from Agawam. How are you?
Good, George. What's on your mind?
Hey, I normally complain about Mr. Nagle over there doing his imitation of Dave Coombs. But, I'd like to point out that for somebody who says that I do a lot of complaining, I believe that Nagle does a lot of complaining about the news sources that he poaches from. So, Nagle, unless you're going to go out there and actually pound the pavement and do it right, if you're stealing from other news sources, then maybe you shouldn't really complain that much about them.
He's not stealing.
Well, first
he's
of
reporting.
All, I'm not a journalist. I'm a ripping reader, and that's been no secret. I don't go out on the street. I'm not doing any reporting. And frankly, George, I can do whatever I want. It's not called the Bax and George Show, is it? It's called the Bax and Nagle Show.
No, but I'm a listener, and since
no, actually, you know what? I will contest that. I will contest that. You don't listen to anything at all.
I'm here, and you're here. Doesn't it make it our show?
Well, actually,
you're a
George,
roadblock, George.
Yeah, George, it seems to me that you are a non-paid component of this show. That listen, you could have a bunch of tainted milk and it'd be less belly aching than what I hear from you, George.
All I complain about is Nagle's constant use of one comedy bit.
Hey, George, I got some news for you. People on the Route 10 Tire listener line saying, hang up on this jerk.
Oh,
well,
man.
That's too bad.
All right. Thank you, George. Have a good day.
Right, pick another call.
Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Hey, back to Nagle. This is Andrew.
What's up, Andrew?
Hey, I know that you guys were talking earlier about the bathroom situation, about the five.
This is what this is the top topic on everybody's mind.
This is what's on everybody's lips.
Yeah. Look. From a person that got thrown, to me, 5 to 10 minutes is not enough time. For me, it's got to be like an hour. I'm literally an hour tops every day in the bathroom. At least 2 to 3 hours.
All right, but you have a specific condition which sometimes requires that.
Yeah, exactly. But I was listening to Steve, and he said that even if sometimes you got some condition, it only would take you 5 to 10 minutes. And I'm like, I understand that sometimes it would take you 5 to 10 minutes. That's depending on the body. but it's super detrimental in the bathroom. You sitting there on your thoughts with pants hanging down, your butt all getting dry.
Yeah.
And it's harder, and it's super detrimental.
I'm sorry.
Put you down.
Just to point this out, the way you said look, you sound like that sound on TikTok that says, look at this. Yeah, that's him. We found him. He lives right here in Western Mass. Holy sh!
Wow. Hey, listen, I wish you all the best in your medical condition. Hopefully someday they'll find a cure for it and you won't have to spend a full hour to yourself.
No. I like to spend at least 5 minutes.
All right. Appreciate it.
Well, thank you. Have a good one.
You too, bud. I like this guy. F. George from Agawam. He's annoying as F.
Oh, come on now. Give George a little bit of love.
Lay off the cheese. You guys get paid? Yes, actually, surprisingly, we do. He wants you to argue with him. Yeah, it's true. He wants you to engage in argument with him.
Yeah.
If he comes up with a good argument, maybe we can engage with him.
I wouldn't be surprised if he's on Dave Coombs' payroll.
Maybe it's the call coming from in the house. They're in the house.
Have you checked the children? Exactly what's going on here.
It's 32 in downtown Springfield. I'm Steve Nagle, and that's the news on
Rock 102, Springfield's classic rock. It's 7:53, and Aerosmith with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Mostly sunny today with a high of 49. Tomorrow, mix of sun and clouds with a high of 48. It's 32 right now in downtown Springfield.
Rock 102 and Aquapump giving you a chance to win a pair of tickets to see New England take on Los Angeles in Foxborough on Sunday, December 29th. Go to rock102.com, sign up for your chance to win. We'll choose a winner on November 25th. It's your chance to win tickets to see New England and Los Angeles, brought to you by Aquapump and Rock 102 Springfield.
What else? Let's see. Of course, there's the I'm continuing this conversation about this bathroom thing because it's so riveting.
You know, it's the kind of thing where, you know, no one really knows what other people do, you know, not only when they're there, but how long it takes.
People kind of
focus on what they do. They're not thinking about what everybody else is doing.
I like to think of this show as kind of an escape from reality, and focus on the mundane things in life. Like, how long should you be sitting on the toilet for? These are all the things that really are the hard hitting issues that we all want to talk about.
You know, I never slap the timer like it's a chess game. You know, it's like when it's my turn, you slap the timer and you try to. I never really timed it out.
Yeah.
It seems like 10 minutes is like maybe probably about right on the low end.
Yeah. Oh, here's a guy. His name is Jose, and he's from Ludlow. And he says, Steve, how does it feel to be fat and not funny?
Well, first of all, you're not fat anymore. You've lost a lot of weight. You're a barrel-chested young buck.
Yeah, I guess I'm still not funny, though. That's the problem.
Well, I can't address that. To each his own.
Why? I don't know why Jose is so upset. What's wrong with Jose?
I don't know. He seems to have an axe to grind.
He seems very upset.
Much like George.
Jose, I implore you to call here. I'd like to talk to you. I'd like to just have a conversation with you and find out what's really... Because... He also wrote back, he's written two messages to the Route 10 Tire listener line.
Yeah.
One was back in February. Is it February or February?
February.
This is Jose from Ludlow. Do us all a favor and stop doing that stupid Kim Kardashian skit. Thank you. And now, in November, what is that, 9 months later?
Mm-hmm.
Steve, how does it feel to be fat and not funny?
You know, that kind of fat shaming, I think, is insensitive, Jose.
We don't
lob insults at you just because you happen to have an axe to grind. Attitude.
Is that Jose on the phone?
I don't know.
Let's find out.
Rock 102. Good morning. Who's this?
Hey, this is Eric.
Oh, you're not Jose.
What's on your mind, Eric?
I just want to chime in on this bathroom thing there, you know?
Yeah, see?
When I got to do my business, I just get in and get out.
Yeah,
but
that's
my wife and my son will go in there and go on TikTok or Facebook.
Get off the damn social media in the bathroom.
Get an hour.
Yeah, get out of the damn bathroom.
You did your business about 10 minutes ago, you know, and then now you sit there for another hour.
Yeah. It's like blocking an ambulance from going to an emergency. If you're in the bathroom and you're just scrolling along on TikTok, and somebody else has an emergency, it's like not pulling over for an ambulance getting out of the way.
Absolutely.
By blocking the bathroom.
I got a problem here. Hurry up.
Yeah, you got the move over law for movements. Yeah. All right, listen, Eric, we appreciate the time, and you have yourself a great day, okay?
You do the same.
All right.
Let's see if Jose's there.
All right. Rock 102, good morning. Who's this?
Hi, this is John from East Hampton.
Nah, you're not Jose. What do you need? What do you want? Well,
my wife and I listen to you guys every morning. She probably isn't listening now because she's taking care of our 3-year-old as a stay-at-home mom.
Yeah. Okay.
But, Anna, if you're listening, I love you, and congratulations on being pregnant with our second kid.
Oh, yeah. Look at you, you straight shooter.
Wait a minute. Your wife is pregnant with your second kid, or you're saying congratulations to Steve and I for a second kid?
Well, that's what she's telling me, so I think so. I think it's her.
Well, then congratulations.
I think it's mine. I got a quick joke for you if you got a sec.
Yeah, why not?
So a vegan and a vegetarian jump off a cliff. Who lands first? Who wins?
I don't know. Who?
Society.
All right, that's a classic.
How do you do, guys?
All right, thank
there you go.
All right,
very good. I know we don't have any more time, but I just would like to say to Jose, right? For two insulting messages 9 months apart from each other, and you ask me how does it feel to be fat and funny? How does it feel to be so disgusted with something you've listened to it every day for 9 months just to complain again?
You bring up a very good point.
It takes all kinds.
It sure does. Yeah. It's 7:58 at Rock 102.
Managers, landlords, handyman, and contractors.
Hey, good morning, sports fans. How the heck are you? As many of you know, this Friday night in Dallas, 58-year-old former heavyweight champion Mike Tyson will be getting into the ring with 27-year-old YouTube sensation Jake Paul. Most people see this fight as a grossly irresponsible and farcical display of needless aggression. A display in which people are wondering whether a man who is nearly 60 years old can tear into a young man like the old Mike Tyson used to do, or whether he's healthy enough to survive a beating from a young man who happens to be 31 years younger than he is. Good questions, but virtually unanswerable until Friday night. Now, here's what I can tell you. The beloved national treasure that we know now as Mike Tyson certainly sounds like the Mike Tyson of old. Remember him? The I'm going to eat your children Mike Tyson, or the I'm going to prison for acting up in a beauty pageant Mike Tyson? That's the guy I remember. It's almost as if that Mike Tyson is back and ready to settle some scores. Yesterday during an open workout, Mike told reporters, quote, I'm bringing the devil himself into the ring. He also stated, my own mother should be careful if she gets in the ring with me. Folks, it's almost as if Mike Tyson never left. Now, I can't speak for Mike Tyson's mother. I mean, the woman's been dead for decades. The devil, on the other hand, appears to have a very busy schedule. Between famines, the natural disasters, pestilence, and maintaining the fiery bowels of hell probably takes up a pretty good portion of his day. I tend to doubt that the omnimalevolent overlord of evil can just peel away himself away from his other obligations and sit ringside just to support Mike Tyson. On the other hand, it appears though Satan does tend to spend most of his weekends in the Dallas-Fort Worth area just to keep tabs on what he's done to the Cowboys this season. Nevertheless, if the devil is planning on going to the fight on Friday night, then Jake Paul might want to think about taking a dive, because I'm pretty sure that the devil wouldn't want it any other way. But hey, enough of my yapping. Sports brought to you by Rockies Ace Hardware. Locks and keys. See Dave at the Island Pond Rockies. Dave cuts house keys, makes specialty keys, locks and keys with all the hardware stuff. Dave at the Island Pond Rockies. Good people, rock solid service at every Rockies Ace Hardware. I'm back. That's my view from the couch.
Rock 102, Springfield's Classic.
Rock 102, Springfield's Classic Rock. It's 8:12 and Brian Adams. With Bax and Nagle at Rock 102.
It is going to be, mostly sunny today with a high of 49. Tomorrow, mix of sun and clouds with a high of 48. It's 32 in downtown Springfield. Great Awakening Brewing over in Westfield is holding a comedy show, a big fat comedy show. I'm convinced Chris Zito gets more airtime here than he does on his actual radio show.
Well, more people hear about him here than they do over there.
And it's going to be me, Chris Zito, this other comedian, John Turco, and a guy who's on the phone with us right now, Gary Marino. Gary, how are you?
Hey, how you doing, pal?
Good. I'm here with my co-host, Mike Baxendale.
How you doing, Gary?
Hey, Bax. How you doing?
I'm terrific.
So, well, I know Steve thought I was sleeping, and in fact, I have been up.
Well, we called you once, and it went right to voicemail, and I'm like, this guy told me he was doing it at this time, and we were going to do this, and now he's not answering the phone. What the hell is going on out here?
I apologize. I was on another call. I saw her come in, and I just said to her, I said, oh, I got to call you back.
Well, there's also the time zone change between Boston and Western Mass. I'm sure you're quite aware of it.
Oh, there's no question. No, those 4 hours kill you. You call it mornings. I call it after hours, boys.
So you're not from Western Mass, but you married a Westfield girl, right?
Well, yeah, I'm from Boston. I'm actually from Medford, just north of Boston, our Italian section where the guys don't speak English or Italian. It's kind of their own thing. But refreshingly, I have to say, 30-something years ago, I did marry a Westfield girl and spent a lot of time out there. You know, I had 2 sets of in-laws, you understand?
Yeah.
Which, you know... I'll be honest with you, Western Mass wasn't always crazy about you, but now I'm doing shows out there. Love you.
Well, what was the problem back then about the Western Mass? Was it the drive, or was it just the way we are?
Nothing wrong with you guys. I just think in-laws are in-laws.
I can see where that can suck to say.
I had two sets of in-laws. One I loved, one not so crazy about. So it was always a little bit of a drag going out there, but... Now that they're no longer my in-laws, I got to tell you.
But
love you, Western Mass.
Did I hear you're getting a divorce though?
I am, in fact. Yeah, just going through that now. A lot of fun.
That's usually how most Westfield marriages end, anyway.
I'm not going to argue with you, buddy.
There's something about the Whip City that just doesn't sit right with people, and after a while, they say, "That's it. I'm done."
Here's what I think happens. I think they grow up out there, and like you said, it's its own thing. Mm-hmm. In the case of my wife, she moved to the big city in 1989, normalized, met me, normalized. I'm going to take credit for that, normalized. And now I think she's reverting back to the Western Mass girl. I'm sorry.
Well, you know, I think a lot of people, Gary, and I think this is true, once you get off the Mass Pike, and you get on that off-ramp in Westfield. I think there are many people who believe that ride from the Pike to downtown Westfield is a trail of broken dreams. You can it was for me when I lived in Westfield for a while, and I know that for many, they feel the very same way.
You know, I'm not going to argue with you there. That said, did I mention I love it out there now? Yeah. I love doing shows out there now. Great audiences, sweet people, and they're the perfect comedy audiences. You're overworked, you're underpaid, you're undersexed, you're mentally broken. You're perfect for a comedy show.
We're all perfect recipe for a great marriage. Overworked, underpaid, right?
You know, guys, it was for me for a lot of years. Yeah. I was lucky enough to be with a rock solid sweetie for a lot of years, and now it's wrapping up as they do. Where was it written Gary Marino is any better than any of you 60% divorced people out there? I mean, let's be honest, boys. 60% of the country is headed for the is divorced. Of the 40% that remain married, who are we kidding? Most of them should be divorced.
Well, I know 50% of my divorce, of my marriages ended the same way. So I kind of understand the math you're talking about here.
What's funny is now people are saying to me, wow, yeah, you're looking good. You're losing weight. Are you taking the shot? Are you taking Manjaro? Are you taking the shot of Wegovy? I go, no, I'm taking shots from a divorce attorney.
Yeah, that's enough to make you not want to eat for a while.
You lose your appetite for a lot of things.
I thank her. I've been looking to push the inner button, boys, and get back into shape, and I thank her for pushing the inner button. I really do.
No.
Let me tell you something. Gary 3.0 is coming out this new year, and he's going to be better than Gary 2.0. I promise you that.
Well, let's hope so.
Yeah, 2.0 was good, but he didn't stick around, and he kind of you know, he didn't stick around long enough, unfortunately. It was like any technical thing, you know, there were glitches.
Now, you are coming to Westfield. You're coming to the Great Awakening Brewing Company on the let's see, it's the 23rd. You're there with 23rd. You're there with Steve, so you know that's going to be good. But then somehow, and I don't know how these things happen, I assume it's just, you know, a booking issue or whatever it is. Chris Zito made the bill too. I don't know how that works. I hope you guys can work through all that.
I have to tell you, full disclosure, it's Zito's show, and he wanted Steve. Big fan. I don't know if the other radio station wants me to say that, but big fan, Steve.
Well, he gave me the lineup. He's going to go first, and then I'm going to come on because I usually bat clean up anyway around here.
I'm looking forward to working with you, Steve. I know we were supposed to work together last summer, and it didn't pan out, but I'm looking forward to sharing the stage with you, and we'll serve it up large, brother.
Yeah, that's actually a pretty nice brewery over there, and they got some good entertainment going on at that place.
Oh, my God. You could park the space shuttle in that brewery. Have you ever seen? It is one huge venue, and it's beautiful. And we did New Year's there last year and a couple of shows since. And it's a great people to work with. The food is really good. Of course, all the beer and spirits is great. And it's just going to be a great night. Listen, we all need to laugh. It's the holidays, boys, right?
Yeah, we do, but can we kind of, like, get rid of the Zito guy? I don't know if we really need him. I mean, we're using him as a pawn to drum up business for the show.
If Zito goes first, now, Gary, follow me, you've been a comedian long enough. If Zito goes first, by the time Steve goes on, they will have forgotten all about Chris Zito.
No question. Yeah, no question. Actually, here's the lineup. Zito goes first. He's the host. He's not headlining. Then it goes, I think, me, Steve. Then you get to follow me, which will be easy. And then we have a great headliner from Boston, John Turco, who's hysterical. As a matter of fact,
I know John. He's John a good, good guy.
John actually headlines my Valentine's show earlier this year called Love is Bat Crazy. And it was an entire lineup of divorcees.
That had to be hilarious.
At the time, I wasn't going through the divorce, so I wrote a whole bunch of stuff about my wife I had planned to do until her friends bought tickets. Then I had to jettison the whole goddamn act.
I can't imagine why you're getting divorced. it blows my mind. I'm not sure.
A divorced woman's best friends with a cell phone and video. It can only end badly in court.
You know what? As I told my wife, you know, I'm a comedian. I'm also a musician, and I told her, you know, I told you loving the music, man, ain't all it was supposed to be, honey. What can I tell you?
Yeah.
Gary Marino is going to be at the Great Awakening Brewing on the 23rd, along with Steve and some other folks, too. Gary, it's great to talk to you. Best of luck, and we'll talk to you soon.
Thanks so much, guys. Hey, Steve, one quick question.
6 inches.
Are you going to wear your World Gone Crazy t-shirt?
I don't have a World Gone Crazy t-shirt. Can I get a World Gone
Crazy t-shirt? Could have sworn in the post that you were wearing a World Gone Crazy t-shirt.
Yes, because somebody photoshopped out Rock 102. You know what? There's some managers here that are none too happy about that.
Hey, I was told what, you know, what I had to do. Blame Zito when you see him.
Oh, absolutely.
You know what? We always do.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, you guys are a lot of fun. Thanks for having me on. And Weston Mass, I love you. Coming out to see you soon.
Sounds good. Gary Marino with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Rock 102.
It's 8:25 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Dan Brown has the full forecast.
The Mayflower Marathon is coming up, and in fact, it's coming up in 12 days. I'm not trying to alarm anybody, but it's right around the corner. And the Open Pantry is desperate for your help this year. 40% more demand on the Open Pantry than last year, when 1 in 4 families were suffering from some level of food insecurity. So the time to get your collection up is right now. For those who've never experienced the Mayflower Marathon, Steve and I are going to be broadcasting for 52 hours starting on November 25th at 6 a.m. and then continuing the broadcast until Wednesday, November 27th at 10 outside the South End Market at MGM Springfield. The goal is to fill as many trailers with non-perishable food donations as humanly possible, but we need your help to do it. Thanks to all of our sponsors, including Capital Moving and Storage, Xfinity, Camping World of West Hadfield, MGM Springfield, and many more. You can get all the details about the Mayflower Marathon and how to help at rock102.com. It's the Mayflower Marathon, 12 days away from today on Rock 102, Springfield's Classic Rock.
That's crazy how fast this comes up every year.
It feels like we were just doing this a month ago.
That's how quickly this goes. I don't know, but even when we didn't have those pre-events that we have, like years prior, you know, the partnership with the Thunderbirds and the comedy show are two things that we didn't do prior to, what, 2022?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but even then, times... Like, this is how I measure my work years here, is how many years I've been here by how many Mayflower Marathons this is.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, oh, okay, this is kind of like the new year for me, because after that's over, it's like, ugh, that's the holiday lull after that.
Yeah, and as far as anyone can tell, we're going with the idea this is our 31st Mayflower Marathon. That's,
you know,
what we're going with.
Why do we even bother doing that?
Well, we're not doing it anymore. I mean, you know,
no,
30 years, that's more of a milestone.
Yeah,
31.
But
it's, like, it's like if you turn, like, you know, 48 years old, who cares?
But this is the problem. If you don't keep counting, if you don't keep doing that,
yeah,
then 10 years from now, when it's the 40th or 41st, whatever one you want to believe it is, We're gonna be arguing about this again.
Yeah.
Well, what time? What day was it? Or what? How many did we do before 1995?
I think we should make a bigger deal of the off years. It's our 34th Mayflower Marathon.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I even tried to do that when I first started working here, when I was putting together like taglines and stuff, and Jerry was here, and then I said, well, how many is this? And he didn't know at the time. So then I was doing 13th, 14th, whatever it was at the time, and that had to be cut out eventually because nobody could remember what year it was.
Well, ironically enough, last year, so Nicole, who runs the Open Pantry, she's the woman in charge, she's been there from the beginning. But I think she might be the only one that's still there. There might be a handful of other people that have volunteered over the time.
She was there for the first one?
She was there for the first
one. She doesn't remember what year that was,
She has documentation that said that last year was the 30th year.
Okay.
And that's according to her. Well, I mean, that's according to her. So this is my 30th.
Yeah.
But last year was the 30th anniversary. So I've been to all of them but one.
This is why poor record keeping prevents society from moving forward.
People go to jail for keeping such lousy records.
Right,
people do time in federal prison for such lousy record keeping.
But here we are running this, Mike Scully calls it the food scam every year, where we're convincing people to come down and donate. But we really need your help.
We absolutely do
need your help.
This year is not a
serious
scam
situation.
It's 8:29. News is next to Rock 102.
Here's your weather.
8:34 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102. It's time for news brought to you by Freedom Credit Union. Freedom is yours. Here's local radio icon Steve Nagle.
Thanks, Bax. A Springfield man faces firearm and drug charges after officers were called to Dawes Street for a ShotSpotter activation. And to reiterate that same sentence, the Springfield police officers were called to the 100 block of Dawes Street for a ShotSpotter activation. Now, I'm not sure if a ShotSpotter was activated, but I believe a ShotSpotter was activated.
Now, what street is that?
That is Dawes Street.
That's Dawes Street.
Yeah. And that whereas they assume that a ShotSpotter activation has occurred. And I'm not sure whether or not the ShotSpotter went off on Dawes Street, but Dawes Street residents were reporting that a ShotSpotter activation happened.
Well, I'm just going to assume that Dawes Street is where a ShotSpotter activation occurred yesterday?
Monday.
Monday.
Yeah.
Monday.
And I believe, though, in all of this craziness, a ShotSpotter was activated on Dawes Street.
I wish you weren't being so vague about this story. It's so unclear what may or may not have occurred on Dawes Street.
Well, I'm not sure if you heard about this, but over on Dawes Street, a ShotSpotter was activated.
No, do tell.
Well, Springfield police went to Dawes Street after hearing that a ShotSpotter might have been activated.
uh, This update, a ShotSpotter activation was spotted on Dawes Street in Springfield.
This is called working for yous. Because it rhymes with news.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what else rhymes with news?
What?
Booze.
Yes, it does.
Right.
Yes,
right.
We should be drinking more of that around here.
Harumph.
Approximately 10 minutes later, 22-year-old Melvin Mercedes Rodriguez of Springfield was arrested on the 700 block of State Street after police found a loaded firearm in his waistband and 14 grams of crack cocaine.
Sound like clues.
Yes, it's like Dora the Explorer.
What's in the backpack?
Gun waistband, crack cocaine, shot spotter. We did it.
Now, did he use a map to get to State Street?
Yeah.
I'm a map.
And then when they picked him up, they're like, swiper, no swiping. Oh, man. These are the things that really get us going here in the morning. Did you hear about in Oklahoma about the tortured prisoners?
I did hear this.
With the baby shark.
Yeah.
I just saw this morning, and let me see if I can pull the article up because I just closed it. Yeah, former Oklahoma jail officers are being sued. Two former Oklahoma jail officers sued for allegedly forcing inmates to listen to baby shark for hours as punishment. Right?
Mm-hmm.
They were put on probation for 2 years. Oklahoma County Special Judge Martha Oakes handed down the order on Thursday after Christian Charles Miles and Gregory Cornell Butler Jr. Well, that's a name.
Mm-hmm.
Gregory Cornell Butler Jr.
It's a very John Houseman type of name.
What kind of music do you listen to?
I prefer Baby Shark.
They were also charged with conspiracy, but prosecutors dismissed the charge. I don't have it. I was pointing at you to...
Oh, you want me to get Baby Shark for... Okay, hold on a second.
All right, let's stop this comedy bit. Let's rewind and see if we can get prepared with that before I actually started reading the story. We missed rehearsal.
I know.
There you go. Yeah. A federal civil rights... federal civil rights lawsuit for four inmates filed in 2021 accused Miles and Butler of using excessive force and discipline tactics described as torture events. Inmates John Basco and Daniel Hendrick alleged that they were forced to stand in a stress position while listening to Baby Shark at different times in late 2019.
Probably very loudly, too.
The suit describes the standing stress position as being left to stand for hours in handcuffs. Basco, unfortunately, died about a year after the suit was filed, and he was found unresponsive in his cell. Officials later determined that he died from an accidental in jail.
Well, how did that get there?
I mean, how safe of a prison are you if you're letting things like fentanyl get inside?
Fentanyl's terrible stuff. But so is the Baby Shark theme song. And I think we can all agree that to have to stand there in an uncomfortable position for hours at a time may be cruel and unusual punishment.
It's not quite as torturous. But torturous enough to sit and listen to the same Tom Petty song every single morning.
No, this is worse.
Another prisoner, Joseph Mitchell, said he was pulled from his cell in November of 2019 and placed in a room where he was forced into a standing stress position for 3 to 4 hours while he was handcuffed behind his back. Officers then played Baby Shark on repeat so loud that it was reverberating down the hallways.
You know that you can go on YouTube and get this song on a 10-hour loop?
Really?
10 hours of Baby Shark.
I don't think that...
You want to get, like, if you're like a hostage negotiator, and you just stood there, like, you know, kind of like John Cusack-like with a boombox over your head.
Oh, like your, what's his name? Roy? What was his name in the movie?
Yeah, I don't remember, but nevertheless, you get whatever you want by playing this over and over again, loudly.
You know, I've noticed that, if you go into... I won't specifically name a fast food restaurant.
What does it rhyme with?
I can't say.
Okay.
All right. And you go in there, and I had to stop one morning to go to the bathroom. Right?
How long you take?
Less than 5 minutes. But so I go in there, and that's kind of the point.
Yeah.
Because I go in there, and the music is blasting so loud inside of that bathroom. To which I said to one of the clerks there, I'm like, what's the deal with the loud bathroom noise? And she said it was to keep people from sleeping in there.
Really?
Yeah. So
in a fast food bathroom.
Well, if you're open 24 hours, you have a bathroom that's open 24 hours. If somebody who doesn't have a place to sleep is looking for a place to sleep, a bathroom in a fast food restaurant, a non-busy, you know, something that's not so busy during the hours of midnight and probably 5 a.m.
Okay.
You know, but I noticed that, and how, like, I'm like, that would make me want to leave, even if I was trying to sleep.
Do you remember what the song was?
I don't remember. It was like 90s, it was like 90s pop music. It was like, I don't know, like Amy Grantish type of stuff.
No, yeah. Who could sleep with that?
Vince Gill, apparently.
Well, I mean, he could sleep with her, but even at some point, the music goes off.
Yeah. Well, I know, right. But yeah, can you imagine listening to that all day?
No, I can't.
That must be worse. Being at a gathering at Vince Gill and Amy Grant's house is probably worse than listening to 3 hours of Baby Shark in a room handcuffed.
I don't know, man. It sounds pretty awful.
Yeah. Let's see. A 33-year-old man in the UK got arrested for flashing a group of women on the street after they made fun of him and joked that he must have tiny you-know-what.
Wallet?
No. Member. He'd been drinking and tried to hit on them at the club. They said he tried to hug him, and they made it clear that they did not want to interact with him. They ran into him again later outside of a pizza place, and that's where the flashing happened. He told the judge that they said his junk must be tiny and made hand gestures indicating how small it was.
Wow, how humiliating.
They probably, if they were from Rhode Island, they would just hold up the size of a soggy
dog. All right, you know what? Honestly.
What?
Get off the Rhode Island. So what did he do? What happened?
He pulled down his pants briefly and showed him what he was packing, but no official word on whether he proved them wrong or not. You know.
Well, isn't that the most important part of the story?
I would think so. But again, we're talking about news sources that are just fed to us, and we're just ripping and reading.
Oh, my God. They'll do a story about how much time you're supposed to spend in the bathroom, but they won't give you the information that everyone wants to know.
No.
Did he prove the point? Did he prove them wrong?
That would have been the first question as a cop. Well, were you wrong? They told a cop who arrested the man and found a small amount of cocaine on him, so they charged him for exposure and drugs. A small amount of cocaine?
Or a very big, thick one.
Oh, really? I got more cocaine in my other pocket. It's pretty large.
Is that a bag of cocaine in your pocket, or are you just enjoying the arrest?
He was just sentenced to 18 months of probation, drug rehab, and he'll be a registered sex offender for the next 5 years.
Oh, boy.
See, congratulations. You made an accomplishment in your life.
Yeah. Well, okay, you're on the registry, but, you know, everyone's going to be asked. From now on, everyone's going to be asking about they're going to need, like, a measurement.
Yeah.
Kind of like, trying to figure out whether you got a first down or not.
What do you get somebody on that registry?
Oh, really? Where are you registered? Bed Bath & Beyond? Or no, just... That
no,
town.
No, the Massachusetts Department of Correction.
I was on their website. I didn't see any gift registry over there.
What's this commissary? Why does everybody want that? What's that? Your Pioneer Valley forecast today going to be mostly sunny with a high of 49. Mix of sun and clouds tomorrow with a high of 49. It's 36 right now in downtown Springfield. I'm Steve Nagle, and that's the news on Rock 102. Oh, yeah.
Are you looking?
Anyway, it's 8:52, and that's Nirvana with Bax and Nagle of Rock 102.
That was the forecast. Done by Kurt Cobain.
Rock 102 and the Springfield Thunderbirds looking to hook you up with a downtown date night. You'll get a $100 gift card to Nadim's, which I could do a lot of damage at Nadim's for $100. And you get a pair of tickets to see the Thunderbirds take on the Charlotte Checkers at the Mass Mutual Center on Friday, November 22nd, which happens to be the Mayflower Marathon game. Enter at rock102.com before the end of the day this Sunday, the 17th, and one lucky winner be chosen at random. It's your chance to win a downtown date night from Rock 102 and the Springfield Thunderbirds. From Rock 102, Springfield's classic rock.
What else? You got anything else going on over there? What's the deal?
Yeah, we're talking about, we're trying to remember exactly what our total was last year at the Mayflower Marathon. And, you know, it's like, we were talking before about, you know, how we kind of look at the Mayflower Marathon as like almost like the beginning of our year.
Yeah.
Like it's that one, like every year is defined by the Mayflower Marathon. The problem that I have, and I think you're starting to have too, is we don't have full recollection of what we did last year, even though it was the best year we ever had.
I don't, I think what the deal with why it feels like a new year to us is because it's so and I mean not draining in a bad way, but it just, it's like mentally, like you're up for that long and you're constantly, like leave here and go home, turn that off. Like I have other things to do. I have a life to go about and not, you know. I mean, I try to tell as many penis jokes to whoever wants to listen throughout the day, but...
But that's just who you are.
Right, right. But for the most part, like, you get to shut that off, and you focus on things that you, you know, everyday things in your life.
I go home, and mostly I sit in silence, like, that first hour or two when I'm home.
Yeah.
Because I just, it's like, you know, having a 4.5 conversation with the same guy every damn day...
I know.
It's draining. It sucks the life out of you. And then, you know, knowing that, you know, we're about, you know, 12 days away from a 52-hour-long broadcast.
Oh, I got to sit and watch you and listen to you. And
I know.
Get fruitcake from people.
Well, I only got one fruitcake last year.
Well, you don't need any more. We do.
Says who?
Says, don't do that. You know who needs fruitcake? The hungry people. Give it to them.
Even many
actually, no.
People
don't
are
torture.
Hungry. They've been through enough.
Yeah, they need like real food. Don't
but yeah, I mean it is exhausting, and it takes a good week for equilibrium to start creeping itself back into your life. But we love it, and it's such a great event, and we're something that we're all very, very proud of, and more importantly, the community should be proud of it because all we do is tell you where to go. You folks are the ones who are doing all the heavy work and all the heavy lifting and the donating and, you know, the big food drives, even the small food drives. I mean, to me, that is great to see and far more impressive than anything that Steve will do or anything that I'll do.
We are just the mouthpieces, the connection between all of the hardworking employees and volunteers that get this thing going.
Yeah.
Then we are the mouthpiece to tell all of you folks to come out and donate. It's one of the greatest examples of community service that you could take a look at if you step back from it and do it from beginning to end, where it starts, where it ends, and it never really ends. But it's for as far as this event goes, it's pretty impressive, and we couldn't do it without you. So let me kiss the butt of the listeners at this moment and say thank you.
Wow, the sincerity that's pouring off of you. I'm so not used to seeing that.
I know. Well, look, somebody drew a penis on his picture.
But that's okay.
Yeah.
That's all right. Ultimately, that's what really matters. But it all begins in 12 short days.
12 days.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I know.
Yeah. So we are looking forward to it. And again, if you haven't done so yet, get your collections together and bring them down on the week of November 25th through the 27th. Downtown Springfield.
It's 8:57 with Bax and Nagle on Rock 102.
Attention football know-it-alls.